Hi, I am ZJ, a data scientist based in Melbourne. I want to talk about this package called diskframe. Have you ever encountered this message? Cannot allocate vectors of size, whatever. So what is the issue here? Well, the issue is that R tries to load the whole data into RAM. So it doesn't really fit sometimes. If your data is quite large, how do you deal with that? In this talk, I'll talk about diskframe, but Apache Spark via, for example, dplyr is also possible. So how does diskframe work? Well, diskframe is very simple. It's just a folder with many FST files. If you're not familiar with FST files, see this website. Each file is called a chunk. And basically, if your data set is too large, I don't have to load everything to memory. I just break that whole data set into smaller chunks and load it chunk by chunk. Now, once I can load the data chunk by chunk, I can do many things. For example, I can operate on the chunks in parallel. So how do you make use of diskframe? Well, the first thing you want to do is load some data into the diskframe format. So the diskframe package has this convenience function called CSV to diskframe. You simply provide a path to the CSV file and it'll convert that to a diskframe. If you have multiple CSVs, you can just pass it a list of CSVs or a vector of CSV paths. Well, I'm going to show you a demo using 1.8 billion rows. So I've downloaded the Fannie Mae dataset. So the first thing you should do when you start a diskframe is run this function called setup diskframe. This will set up parallel processing for you. As I mentioned before, I've created a folder with many FST files in this directory. So I can show you the content of this directory. As you can see, it's just a bunch of FST files. So to make use of these FST files, I just call this function called diskframe. And I can look at the head and tail, just like a normal data frame. I can see things like the end row. So you can see there's 1.8 billion rows in this data set. And the CSV unzipped would be about 200 gig in size. So there's some more functions, number of columns, and the names of the columns. So you can operate a diskframe almost like as if you have a data frame. One of the key features of diskframe is that I've implemented the dplyr verbs, so you can make use of dplyr verbs directly to manipulate the data. So I start with the diskframe I created. I run this function called source keep, and this is very important. This is actually what makes diskframe fast. So a source keep basically tells the program which columns to load into memory. Because there's 31 columns, for this particular analysis, I only needed these four columns. So I only need to load these four columns into RAM. So I just filter like you would normally do with the dplyr, do a mutate and then group by year, which is created here, and do a summarize and finally collect. So let's run that. While that's running, I will show you what's happening with the task manager. Most of the CPUs are being utilized, and that's because it's processing all the chunks in that data set in parallel. Well, as you can see, I've done a group by and created new columns in the meantime in about 1 minute. This was done on the Fannie Mae data set with 1.8 billion rows. To learn more about diskframe, simply go to diskframe.com. I'd like to finish off by pointing out a couple of things. If you do have Spark, it's perfectly fine to use it, but not everyone's lucky enough to have a Spark cluster set up. So diskframe, you can use R functions directly, even those defined by the user. Thank you.